Hello everyone, welcome to MSFT webcast. This is the fourth part of this ongoing video series on how to deploy two-tier public key infrastructure using Windows Server 2019. In the last video, we have successfully deployed Enterprise Subordinate Certification Authority on this Windows Server 2019. We have also defined the new location of CDP and AIA as well. Everything was working fine at that point. But when we checked for ADCS health status in Enterprise PKI tool, there were some errors which we need to fix. Let me again show those errors. Here on this console, you can see this error, but again, I want to refresh this to check whether we're still receiving these errors or not. Let's click on refresh button. And as you can see, we're still receiving error on our offline root CA. If we click on our Enterprise Subordinate CA, there are no error. Everything is in a okay condition. And in a normal condition, if you click on your CA name, you will see information about CA certificate, authority information access CRL extension location, CRL distribution point location, and delta CRL location, which should all be healthy for a properly working public key infrastructure. But in our case, here we have some errors and we need to fix those errors. As you know that we have already configured custom web-based CDP and AIA extensions on our offline root certification authority as well as on our enterprise subordinate certification authority. Here you can see that URL is there. If you click on our subordinate CA, we have the same URL, but here everything is working fine. But in this case, here you are receiving messages that unable to download. And one thing which you have to notice here is, see the name of certificate and CRL file. It should be offline root underscore offline root hyphen CA dot CRT. And in a second, in CDP location, it should be offline root hyphen CA dot CRL. If we click on our enterprise subordinate CA, here the names are different. And that's the reason that why we are facing error on our offline root CA. See, might be initially you will find this video a little bit confusing one. But at the end, everything will be clear to you. First, let me show you that custom web-based CDP and AIA extensions, which we have configured on our local certification authority. Let's go to CA. On certification authority console, let's click on our CA name, right click here and go for the properties. Okay, let's click on extensions. And here you can verify that we have the location under CDP. http://www.mylib.local/cert-enroll, and then certain variables are there related to that certificate name. And you don't have to specify anything for this. This will be automatically generated. And if you check for AIA, the same URL is mentioned there. That is http://www.mylib.local/cert-enroll. Fine. So this is the URL which we have specified under our issuing certification authority. Let's go back to our PKI view console. And here you can see on offline root CA, we are getting error on this URL. So I'm going to select it. Let's copy this URL and try to access in Internet Explorer. Let's paste that URL here and let's press Enter key. As you can see, we are not able to access it. And here we are receiving error that HTTP error 404.0 not found. Let's try to access only there's a directory, which is www.mylib.local/cert-enroll. Let's remove this portion and let's press Enter key. Here, we are still getting that error, HTTP error 403.14 forbidden. The web server is configured to not list the content of this directory. And we can solve this problem by opening IIS Manager console. So on Server Manager, let's click on Tools. And let's click on Internet Information Services Manager. That is going to open IIS Manager console. Let's maximize it. So remember, on this server, we have also installed Certification Authority Web Enrollment Service. Before we do anything in Internet Information Manager console, let me show that local Certification Authority Web Enrollment site. Let's press Enter key. And here we go. Let's specify the user's credential. Let's press Enter key. Okay, this is the home page of CA Enrollment Web Services. From this console, user can request for a certificate or you can download CA certificate, etc. But we are more interested in a CertSRV. If we click on this tab, here we have a cert enroll and here we have a cert SRV that we want to verify in IIS Manager Console. So let's expand our local server. Here we have a sites, and under default site, you can see we have one virtual directory with the name cert enroll, and here we have one cert SRV virtual directory as well. Now, let's come back to the point where we are getting error for cert enroll. I'm going to close it so you don't have a confusion related to that cert SRV. Here, the error is the web server is configured to not list the content of this directory. So let's go back to IIS Manager, and for that, we simply need to click on cert enroll, and let's double click on directory browsing, and we need to enable it. So we need to enable directory browsing on cert enroll. Let's click on enable. Fine, we have successfully modified those settings. Let's again go back to Internet Explorer and let's click on refresh button to refresh this web page. Fine, and this time you are able to see those certificates which we are talking about. If we click on PKI View Console, let me click on our subordinate CA. Sorry. Let me scroll a little bit so we can see these URLs properly. Fine. Here you can see those entries are there, mylab-mylab-issuing-sub-ca.crl, and that those certificates are available here, and that's the reason that why we are not able to see error on our enterprise subordinate CA. But if we click on offline root CA, here we don't have the certificate with this name. You can verify that. Here we have a whatever certificate with the MyLab names. We don't have any certificate with offline root certification authority. And that's the reason that why we are getting these errors. So to fix this, we need to find these two certificates and we need to store those certificates under this location. Fine. So first thing which I'm going to do is let's click on IIS Manager. Let's expand our default site. Let's click on cert enroll. I know the exact physical location of this folder, but still I want to show you. Let's right click here and select explore. This is the location which we have seen on our offline root certification authority. If you remember, in the second part of this video series, we have copied two certificates to our C drive. These are the certificates which we have copied. Security certificate with AIA and certificate revocation list. And these certificate files were initially stored on this location on our offline root certification authority. So to fix this error, we simply need to do only one thing, that we need to copy these two files which we have copied from our offline root certification authority to this location. Just simply paste here. Fine. And now your problem is fixed. Let's go back to Internet Explorer. And first I'm going to refresh this. Okay, here we can see those certificates are listed here. And let's go back to PKI View Console. Let's click on Enterprise PKI and let's click on Refresh button. And now this time you can see status is okay. If you click on Offline Root CA, this location is accessible. Means we can access the location for AIA and CDP location. And if you click on MyLab-MylabIssuing-sub-CA, means our Enterprise Subordinate CA, this everything is working fine. So now if you click on Enterprise PKI, everything with okay status. So our PKI environment is in a properly working condition. Let me tell you the reason that why I have installed Certification Authority Web Enrollment Service on this server. If we install Certification Authority Web Enrollment Service, that will create this virtual directory on IIS Manager. So you don't have to create these folders or virtual directory or permission, etc. on your subordinate certification authority. One more thing which I want to show you. If you click on this cert enroll folder, let's right click on it and go for the properties. On sharing tab, this folder is shared. We haven't shared it, but this folder is automatically shared because we have deployed Enterprise Subordinate Certification Authority on it. And the configuration wizard will automatically share this folder. Second thing, by default, whenever you publish any CRL list, that is going to store under this location. So I have used Certificate Authority Web Enrollment Service for this directory, and I have pasted all my CRL and AIA certificate files on this location, so we don't have to specify any additional location in this extensions URL. Let's click on extensions, and this is the URL which I'm talking about. Suppose if you want to publish your CRL distribution point or AIA location on another web server, that time you can. But for that, you need to manually set up everything on that server. Instead of, we are using this location, and even if in the future, if we modify anything, we don't have to change anything on another server. If you change anything, and if you want to create a new CRL list, or if you want to publish new CRL list, that time simply you need to right click here, select all task and select publish. Before new CRL publishing, I want to show you, see the current timestamp. Here it is telling us that 237, fine, this is a timestamp we have. Now, let's click on OK button. Let's wait for it. Let's go back to cert enrolled folder. Let's right click here and select refresh. Here you can see the timestamp is updated. So now we have a up to date certificate revocation list. And that's the reason that in most of guide which you will find on the internet on subordinate CA, every time admin will install certification authority web enrollment. So we don't have to do the manual configuration. See, I have tried my best to explain everything in my words. If you guys still face any problem or have any confusion related to this videos, let me know in a comment section. I'll try my best to answer you guys. So after seeing this, we can safely say that we have successfully deployed two-tier public key infrastructure using Windows Server 2019. That concludes our video demonstration. Thank you all for watching this video.